The reason that they tie a rope around your waist is because quite often your body shuts down. And it's not really a glamorous Baywatch rescue in Antarctica. No one really wants to dive in after you. So instead they haul you out like you're some kind of giant trawler fish.
But
the reason I use this image is because it sums up a challenge I went on with my best friend in 2015. He's the only person crazy enough that when I call him and say, "Hey, I've got a great idea," says, "Awesome, I'm in," before I tell him what it is. And he made that fateful error heading into 2015. And I said, "I've just finished reading this book called Daring Greatly. That talks about this idea that it's the things we're afraid of that we most need to do." He said, "Yeah, what's your point?" I said, "Well, I kind of want to guinea pig that idea. Every day for a year, I want us to do something we're afraid of." He said, "Awesome, I'm in." And we went on this crazy journey we called Fear Factor 15, where every day for a year, we committed to doing something we were afraid of. We had an app that we logged it in, there were consequences, you know, you name it. But it was the most unbelievably powerful year, personally, professionally, you name it. And it was interesting, I did all sorts of stuff. I took acting and singing lessons, which will not be demonstrated this morning. I pitched ideas that I never would have had the courage to give life to. I stepped out 2 feet into my business, left big corporate life, and went 2 feet in. A whole raft of decisions over the course of the year that were big fear factor leaps, kind of like the one I've shown there. Actually, the really powerful thing we learned about fear, or one of the many powerful things we learned about fear that year, was it's not about hurtling yourself outside of your comfort zone part. It's actually this piece around making the commitment to routinely take a step. Even if it's a baby step, even if it's once a month, once a quarter, you name it. The power of stepping outside of your comfort zone is your comfort zone expands. When you meet fear and you look it in the eye and you walk through it, the apocalypse doesn't happen. Your confidence grows. And it's not that you run out of things you're afraid of, they're continually there. It's that power that Mark Twain says in his quote, it's not the absence of fear, it's the mastery of it. That's key. And so for me, one of the biggest things I can encourage you to think about is, if we think about that notion of unicycling, eyes up to the horizon, making a call as to where our business is heading, or where our industry is heading, where our community is heading. What's your commitment in terms of the pedal look like? What's the way you're going to give license to a new idea? What are you going to try? What are you going to enable your team to do differently? How are you going to push yourself outside your comfort zone? Because the power of it is unbelievably extraordinary. In fact, so much so that we've committed to doing it all over again in 2016, and we're doing our second year of fear. And I would love, one of my favorite things is when people let me know how they've taken on a fear. So if you choose to take the challenge on, even if you just do it once, please let me know how you go and the impact the experience had on you. Because it's just been an absolute game changer in every regard for us.